First it was Optus, then Medibank. Now one of Australia's biggest online retailers is the latest high-profile company to grapple with the impacts of hackers. But while we're all acquainted with what data breaches usually look like, this one is a little different.
The backlash is furious.
My account was hacked. Over $3,000 spent.
$1,348 spent on Christmas Day. Very distressing.
Not good enough that your phones have been turned off.
Of course, I can only talk to the bot who can't close my account immediately.
Customers of The Iconic flooding social media, unimpressed with the company's handling of their data after a spate of fraudulent orders were made from accounts that had been hacked.
I got a refund in credits on The Iconic, like, recently, and, like, now I'm thinking, if that's got hacked, I've got, like, $500 worth of credit there that someone could steal.
The fashion and lifestyle retailer has since promised full refunds. But this isn't just your regular data breach. The Iconic confirming the company's website itself hadn't been the victim of a cyber attack. Instead, those affected have been subjected to what's known as credential stuffing. And no, it's not something you put in a roast chicken.
Credential stuffing is probably the simplest sort of attack there is. Basically, if you're using the same username and password in other places, then when those other places get compromised in a breach, the bad guys discover everyone's usernames and password, then the bad guys can try the information they've learned already for free and see if it'll get them into The Iconic.
Almost two-thirds of people use the same passwords across multiple accounts, making themselves easy targets.
I've got like four or five little combinations that I roll through.
Never want to forget it. It's just a lot easier if you just have the same one.
I forget, so I just like just use the same thing the whole time.
But the solution is simple.
You don't want to use the same password in multiple places. If you use the same password and account name, then you're just really asking for trouble.
Experts urging us to switch things up before it's too late.
Certainly, we've got to develop a whole lot of new habits. Introducing multi-factor authentication, no businesses want to do that. They don't really want to make it harder for people to buy. I'd suggest most people use a password manager.
I think now after hearing this, I'm definitely going to be switching it up left, right and centre.
I nearly want to go home and change all my passwords now.
Well, there's a new fear unlocked.
Yeah, I didn't know about this one.
I use the same password for most things, slight variations. And I tried to mix it up when I got back to work. I've locked myself out of my work computer. I can't remember what I
That's
what
why
I came
you're not replying
with.
To my email for drinks tomorrow
yes,
night.
Yes, that's exactly right. Mm. Yes.
Mm. I do get the emails and I didn't get an invite. So not to get yourself locked out. That's just hurtful.
Yeah, this is scary. I've only got one password as well. And so
you're kidding.
Only one.
I love Channel 10 69. That's it. No, but I need more. And Jules, my girlfriend, is like, you have to have more. Because I rely on when they send you the text and I'm like, I'm safe. It doesn't matter. But
yeah, there's no two-factor. Yeah, there's none of that happening with this one. I feel like people were let
down.
Are
you falling for the text, like the scam text?
Oh, when it's like, you owe us all this money, ATO. Well, I often do owe the ATO a lot of money. So constantly like, this does, if the shoe fits, it's kind of that vibe.